Thank you. land of nurture and nature. Of art and architecture. A country of elegant serenity, where the wisdom of the past informs the most contemporary of visions. A place most exceedingly rare. Qatar.
It's a beautiful country, Qatar. We are at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium in Doha. And match number 11 is about to begin between Flying Oryx and Falcon Hunters. And remember, Falcon Hunters, if they win tonight, they will become the second team to reach the semi-finals. Swift Calipers have already cemented their place in the top four. Crowd is building up, and my partner Ravi Kant Singh is with both the captains for toss.
We're ready for the toss for this match between Falcon Hunters and Flying Oryx. Match manager Aminul Islam to hand over the coin. It is the Falcon Hunters captain, Iqbal Hussain Chaudhary. Head is the call.
It is tail.
It's landed tails. So, what have you decided?
Well, we're going to bowl first again.
Chasing wasn't the best yesterday. No change in tactics?
No, chasing was very good yesterday. I guess we chased it like the match was like one-sided. But today, like, our plan is going for a chase as well. We have some good bowlers. We have received some reserve players as well from the Pakistan Associates. So we're going to really bounce back and we're going to win. We need to fix our spot for the semis.
Well, 2 points today will guarantee you a place in the semifinals. Are you aware of that?
Yeah, I know that. We know that actually, and we are really looking forward for it.
Well, all the best to you. Talat batting first again. Challenge?
Yeah, it's a challenge because second time Diu works for the other team. We also want to ball first. But the good thing is we got some international and associate player back. So we got a good batting line.
What kind of a target are you looking at? Because Galapagos are scoring 100 plus every match.
Yeah, I guess we have to score 120, 125. Because that's the pass score. And with that, you have to do a good bowling.
Well, all the best to you. So news from the centre is Falcon Hunters have won the toss and decided to bowl first.
Thank you so much, Ravi. So Falcon Hunters, they need a win and they will guarantee their place in the semi-finals. Crowd is very patiently waiting for this match to begin, which will begin in a short while. We'll take a short break and we'll be back with the live action. some beautiful pictures from the beautiful country of Doha. Tradition mixed with the modernism. Ravi and I, and alongside our producer Shirdar Rao, have explored some parts of Doha, and it is a must-visit country with your family. And it is a must-visit place if you want to see a good game of cricket. Match number 11 coming up. Flying Gorex are taking on Falcon Hunters from in the Asian Town Cricket Stadium in Doha. Ravikant Singh is now joining me in the comm box. I am Sunil Taneja.
Certainly a challenge now for the Falcon Hunters, because they are on one win away from booking a berth in the playoffs. So the batsman we'll have to wait and see how things pan out. At the moment, it's Flying Oryx versus Falcon Hunters. Oryx asked to bat first. Hussain Tarat is the captain of the side. So let's see how well can Chaudhary Hussain Iqbal can marshal his resources.
As we mentioned, they're just a win away from the semi-final spot. And as far as Flying Oryx is concerned, they have played three matches, won one, lost one, one was abandoned, so have 3 points. They will also move to 5 if they win. Will find themselves in a comfortable place, but the opponents, Falcon Hunters, will guarantee their spot in the semis if they win.
Certainly a big challenge this is for Flying Oryx, because they started with the win, 9-wicket win over Pearl Gladiators, but then were felled by Desert Riders in their second outing. And their match rained off on day 4.
As far as Falcon Hunters is concerned, they won their first match, beat Heat Stormers by 6 wickets. Then they lost to Swift Gallopers, who won by 6 runs. And the third match, Falcon Hunters won yesterday by 6 wickets with 11 balls remaining. On your right is Mr. Yusuf Jiham Al-Kuwari, the Honorable President of Qatar Cricket Association, making this grand event possible with this very able team.
Well, certainly full marks to the Qatar Cricket Association for putting all this together. And a fair crowd has turned up on this weekend, Thursday, Friday being the holiday. So Falcon Hunters, it will be with left arm Asad Maqsood. Waqas Maqsood, beg your pardon. Waqas Maqsood to get us underway. Chilly evening in the desert. Certainly calls for some heavier clothing to be pulled out.
Mr. Faisal Sandhu. With Miss Babita Garg, so the co-owners of Pearl Gladiators, always happy smiling faces, encouraging all the teams, all the players. Good to see the team owners coming daily and encouraging the players. Pearl Gladiators right now at the bottom of the table without any win so far, but it's good to see the team owner encouraging them. Good to see the families. The best part of the best shot of any match is the families turning out to watch live sport.
Certainly a lot of interest in cricket, as can be seen from the attendance here. There you see one of the stands almost three quarters full. There you see crowds have turned up in large numbers to witness this action here at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. one of the main cricket stadiums in this state of Qatar. Plenty of excitement anyway, because the national day of Qatar is also around the corner. Mohammad Naseem, the on-field umpire, checking with the TV umpire Javed Ashraf, calls play immediately.
So no slip in place. A deep third man, a deep fine leg. The bowler is Waqas Maqsood, already a wicket under his belt. Starts with a wicket, outside edge it is. What a start for the Falcons. Falcon hunters hunt on the first ball. Clap from Mr. Sandhu.
This is called a dream start for the bowling side. First delivery, outside edge, pouched by Rizlan behind the stumps. No mistake whatsoever. So a wicket of the very first delivery for Waqas Maqsood. And Flying Oryx have lost a wicket without a run on the board. Waqas Maqsood has Waqas Maqsood has picked up a wicket with the first delivery and allows Hussain Talat to get off the mark. The captain had to come and face the very second ball of the innings. Remember, this is a 10 over the side game. That's the wicket for you. A wicket for the run. And now all eyes on the Flying Oryx, trying and get a good start, because they need to win to stay in semi-final reckoning.
And Waqas Maqsood does a Mughis Bajwa, gets a wicket on the first ball of the innings. They did it while protecting their score. So on strike right now is Asad Burham, local boy. So over the wicket. Swing and a miss. No slip at place, but Waqas Maqsood would be delighted. Got a wicket on the first ball of the match.
Looked like he was trying to hit the ball all the way to the Hamad International Airport, which is not very far. This is the first wicket of the very first delivery. Rizlan has absolutely no problems pouching that one. Outside edge, flying straight into the gloves of the keeper.
It was second wicket for him in the league, Waqas Maqsood. That's wicket number two, is it? Umpire is not impressed. Appeal was also half-hearted. It did touch something, Ravi, probably the thigh pads.
Well, cut back in very sharply. And, well, came off the thigh pad. Very good decision by the umpire. Had absolutely no contact with the bat. The bat coming on very late. After the ball had gone past, went off the back thigh.
What an excellent start from number 94, Waqas. Tries to clear the infield. One bounce to the fielder. Burham off the mark with that very dangerous shot.
Trying to clear the infield at every opportunity. That's what the batsmen try and do in the first three overs. This time not able to connect properly. Lucky that it didn't carry to the mid-on fielder. Fell well short. brings his captain onto strike now, Hussain Talat.
59 not out in the first match was a score by Waqas Maqsood. Still the highest by any batsman in one match. Hussain Talat, beg your pardon, he will take a single off the last ball. Successful first over, 3-for-1 after one.
Salman Butt there on your screen, the one of the star players on the side, going away to his fielding position at the square pound, point boundary almost. Point inside the 30-yard circle, beg your pardon, and Ahmad Butt had a fair pounding yesterday at the hands of the swift gallopers. Ali Imran taking full toll, 5 sixes were hit off his final over. Take long to forget that kind of a pounding. Hussain Talat now on strike to Ahmad Butt.
Tries to go over the infield, finds the man. The opponent captain, Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain, makes no mistake. Wicket number 2 down in the second over.
First delivery of the first 2 overs have produced a wicket each. There you see, trying to get it over the infield. Talat doesn't get the distance on it. An easy take there by Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain. And Ahmad Butt is ecstatic, as he should be getting success with the first delivery that he bowled in the match. So Talat departs for just 2. And flying Oryx are now 2 down for 3 runs. New batsman is Shahid Yusuf for Flying Oryx. Struggling at the moment. This time down the leg side. Can't take a single as the man comes charging in. That's Taimur Sajjad. And Yusuf is there because this happened of the previous delivery. Hussain Talat trying to drive one straight down the throat of Iqbal Hussain Chaudhary. Second success there for Falcon Hunters.
Wicket on the first ball of the first over and the wicket on the first ball of the second over. That ball showed some movement, the lateral outside movement. So Ahmad should be ecstatic. Must have forgotten the last over of the last game.
Kids enjoying themselves, keeping track of the action that's going on in the field. Good to see youngsters turn up in fair numbers here. Ahmad Butt
completely misjudging on that occasion. Direct hit. Third umpire will make a decision. Looks very close, Ravi.
TV umpire Javed Ashraf immediately called to action. Direct hits are always very, very tricky for the batsman. There you see the throw going in, and well. Maybe just outside the line when the ball makes contact. Yes. Yes. The bail's about to be dislodged. Yes. So the underhand return from Imad, but having a much better day, Imad throws the ball into the stumps, and we are waiting. There's the signal out on the big screen. So the third wicket goes down for the Flying Oryx, and Falcon Hunters are showing absolutely no mercy. Burham, the non-striker, has to depart, and things going from bad to worse. Burham goes for one, 3 for 3 Flying Oryx.
New man in Saad Naseem on the non-striker's end. No need to run for that. First boundary for the team. Already in a very bad shape. 3 for 3, now 7 for 3. Courtesy that leg by.
Doesn't matter how they come, as long as they keep coming. Extras open their account with 4 leg byes. But Falcon Hunters have a star-studded batting lineup. One of them just walked past on your screen, Salwan Bhatt. They also have South African legend Hashim Amla in the squad. But at the moment, lot of recovery required for Flying Oryx. Last delivery of this over. An appeal and given. Imad Bhatt strikes again. Falcon Hunters corners are ecstatic in the VIP box, and shouldn't they be? 4 wickets down, 2 overs gone, and that's all the yield for them, just 7 runs. Imad Bhatt hitting the pad straight away, no doubt absolutely in the mind of the umpire, and the finger goes up immediately. So another wicket gone. This is Saad Naseem gone for a duck. 7 for 4, Flying Oryx. Great start from Falcon Hunters. Already taken 4 wickets in the 2 overs. 3 wickets fell in the second over. 7 for 4 after 2. Flying Oryx, they're not flying at the moment.
That's wicket number five. Oh, no, no, no. Very, very close to that outside edge. Ravi, what a start.
What a ball there. Coming back into the batsman. Nearly got the edge. VIP gallery glued. This is the last wicket, the fourth number four. Loud appeal and immediately gets the confirmation from the umpire. Kaisar Wahid there. Waqas Maqsood. One wicket to him so far. This time connects and connects well, but very well fielded at point. Absolutely no chance. The ball flying to the point fielder. That was Kamran Khan. Took a good catch yesterday as well. Got the favorable bounce, but very well to keep his body behind the ball, Kamran Khan.
The new man in is Chaturanga Silva. Of course, on the non-striker's end, Yusuf also yet to open his account. He'll do it now. Sigh of relief for him. Four wickets already down for just 8 runs, Ravi. It's the last over of power play.
My colleague Ganu Sharma there, also seated in the VIP box. Chaturanga Silva, De Silva now on strike. Ahmad Butt picked up 2 wickets, plus had a hand in the run out as well. So Ahmad Butt having a much better day tonight than what he had yesterday, struggling against the swift gallopers. At the receiving end of the sword-like smashing from Ali Imran. Maqsood this time.
Good length from the bowler. Chaturanga De Silva, the man from Sri Lanka, trying to free his arms straight away. Not successful.
Don't have much of a choice. Remember, this is match number 11. Six-team league. Each team plays each other once, and the top four go into the semi-finals. 1 versus 4, 2 versus 3, 10-over contest. Swift gallopers have 300-plus scores in a row.
This time he does it in style. A bounce over the ropes. Chaturanga De Silva off the mark.
Pure power. Horizontal blade doing the talking. Smashed it straight behind the bowler. Long off and mid off, both inside the 30-yard circle. So absolutely no danger there because we're still in the power play overs.
What a power play for the bowling team. They've taken 4 wickets and given only 12 runs. The kid is also enjoying the great bowling. Only one boundary so far. That's very, very disciplined bowling. Could be out. It's high in the air. The keeper makes no mistake. Half the team down inside the power plays.
Wicketkeeper Rizlan kept his cool, loudly called for it so that there is no obstruction. And of course, when the keeper is going for it, other fielders better stay away because he's the man with the gloves on, pouches it comfortably. You had to wait for it to come out of the night sky, and then absolutely no mistake. The second wicket for Waqas Maqsood. Chaturanga De Silva gone for 4, 12 for 5 flying oryx.
Sound wala bola fatafat sound wala interview kar lete hain.
Harmandeep Singh is the new man in. Half the side already back in the dugout as the power play is completed. This is the last wicket. Trying to slog it. Chitranga da Silva only ended up skying as far as the keeper. Didn't have any distance on it, and very well judged by the keeper Rizlan. One more look at the skyer. Not easy to judge these coming out of the night sky, but then Rizlan has got the gloves on. Second catch for him. Half the side already back in the dugout, just 12 on the board. Power play completed. So Chaudhary Iqbal must be very, very happy. Murad Khan has got the ball now. Local lad Murad Khan bowling to Harmandeep. Oh, wide outside the off stump. Harmandeep trying to reach for it, but no luck. Here the wickets. This is the first one to go. Edge, then straight to the fielder. Tarat Khan. This one was a run out. Very well taken by Imad Butt. Then the leg before, double strike by Imad Butt, and then the catch of Waqas Maqsood. This time it's been pushed, and a direct hit could have had again the TV umpire interested. Very, very risky single. Flying Oryx need those runs, but can ill afford to lose more wickets. That's how tantalizing the situation is. Taimur Sajjad, the man with a throw, disappointed, can't get it through. Not a very happy dugout there. Look at the fall of wickets. 0, 3, 3, 7 and 12. Current score 13 for the loss of 5. So as action continues, 13 for 5. Yusuf, Saad Yusuf, it is on strike, looking around. Murad Khan chops it down, will pick up another easy single. Three deliveries gone. Harmandeep back on strike. Need to get 8 and over to even reach 66. That's not a very healthy looking score. Need to get plenty more than that, especially against a side like Flying Falcon Hunters. This time outside edge, flies to third man. Harmandeep is also struggling to get his timing. Murad Khan, there you see, off the leading edge. Short of catch, but he knew fielder was nowhere near that. Yusuf back on strike. Ball in. Yusuf chops this one onto his stumps, trying to hit that ball square of the wicket, and Flying Oryx sink into even bigger trouble. Way outside the off stump, inside edge, onto the stumps, and that is the end of the innings for Saad Yusuf. Gone for two, Flying Oryx now in deep, deep trouble. Six down for 15.
Break, last over. खेल जाएंगे न्यू बैट्समैन बिलावल बिलावल इकबाल
New batsman in Bilawal Iqbal, 21, his best so far. Needs a big, big innings to pull his team out of trouble. Last delivery of this over. Murad Khan has also picked up a wicket. Played away quietly to point throw. A direct hit would certainly have the umpires interested. Four overs gone, six down for 16, flying Oryx.
Sunil, Sunil, one ball and I'll throw. Main bata dun. Too many W's.
Too many W's in that over detail that you see at the bottom. Five of them appear one after the other. This is the wicket for Murad Khan. Chopped it onto his stumps. Saad Yusuf. So Murad Khan becomes the third bowler for the Falcon Hunters to be among the wickets. And he's also the third bowler to be used by his captain. As the bowler, Saad bin Zafar, gets ready. We'll go over to Sunil Taneja, who's got the Swift Gallopers captain with him, Kamran Akmal. Over to you, Sunil.
Thank you so much, Ravi. With me is, of course, the captain of Swift Gallopers, Kamran Akmal. Bahut bahut mubarak, Kamran. पहली टीम बन गई है आप सेमीफाइनल जाने वाले
जी बिल्कुल क्रेडिट जाता है पूरी टीम को जैसे एफर्ट से खेले हैं आफ्टर फर्स्ट मैच जो हम लोग हारे हैं उसके बाद लड़कों ने बड़ी मेहनत की है गलतियों पे हम लोगों ने गलतियां जो की थी फर्स्ट मैच में उसके बाद रिपीट नहीं की और अच्छा एक बैटिंग यूनिट अच्छा स्कोर बोर्ड पर स्कोर लगा रहे हैं जिसकी वजह से मैच
जीत है यहाँ जोरदार अपील हुई है अंपायर सहमत नहीं लेकिन आपकी टीम ने तीनों जो मैच जीते हैं कामरान पहले बैटिंग करके जीते और तीनों बार आपने 100 का आंकड़ा पार किया है मतलब बैटिंग माशाल्लाह कमाल कर रही है आपकी
जी बिल्कुल बैट्समैनों को क्रेडिट जाता है शहरी जहीर को जैसे स्टार्ट दे रहा है फिर अली इमरान आया उसने बड़ा अच्छी बैटिंग की है दोनों मैचेस में आप देखें कि ऑलराउंड परफॉर्मेंस उसकी और सबको जिम्मेदारी का पता है सब के T10 क्या गेम है क्या मोमेंटम रखना वही एटीट्यूड से खेल रहे हैं तो इसलिए कामयाब भी हो रहे हैं फिर हमारी बॉलिंग जो मुगीज़ और जैनुद्दीन जो बॉलिंग कर रहे हैं नए बॉल पे वो बड़ा अच्छा कर रहा है हमारी टीम के लिए
मैं वही पूछने वाला था कि मुगीज़ बाजवा और जैनुद्दीन को क्या खिला के लाते हैं हर दोनों के दोनों बॉलर पहले दो विकेट दो ओवर में दो तीन विकेट निकाल लेते हैं
नहीं वह बस लाइन टू लाइन पे बॉलिंग कर रहे हैं जो एक रिक्वायरमेंट है पावर प्ले की तो उसमें वो कामयाब हो रहे हैं अच्छा हमारी टीम के लिए मेहनत कर रहे हैं सबको हमारी टीम को इतना हाईली कोई रेट नहीं कर रहा था तो मेरे ख्याल से उमर गुल के आने से अली इमरान फिर मोहम्मद इमरान के आने से एक अच्छा हमारा यूनिट बन गया तो एक मोमेंटम चाहिए होता है एक विक्ट्री चाहिए होती है जैसे हम लोग पहला मैच जीते हैं अच्छी टीम से इस टूर्नामेंट की बेस्ट टीम से उससे बड़ा कॉन्फिडेंस आता है लड़कों में तो यही चीज़ है कि इस चीज़ को कंटिन्यू रखा और क्वालिटी वाइज क्रिकेट भी अच्छी हो रही है क्राउड आ रहा है तो मेरे ख्याल से बड़ा अच्छा साइन है कतर की क्रिकेट के लिए ऐसी लीग इंटरनेशनल प्लेयर्स आ रहे हैं तो अच्छा है कि ऐसे टूर्नामेंट हों ऐसे प्लेयर्स आएँ खेलने तो लोकल प्लेयरों को बड़ा फ़ायदा होगा
चलिए ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट कामरान बहुत बहुत मुबारक उम्मीद करते हैं आप जैसे उमर गुल जैसे बड़े बड़े स्टार यहाँ खेलेंगे कतर की क्रिकेट को और बेनिफिट होगा और ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर द सेमीफाइनल्स
थैंक यू वेरी मच
दिस वाज कामरान अकमल द विनिंग एंड हैप्पी कैप्टन ऑफ स्विफ्ट गैलपर्स बैक टू यू रवि
थैंक यू सुनील एक्शन कंटिन्यूइंग इन द मिडल अनदर सिंगल फ्लाइंग ऑरिक्स स्ट्रगलिंग फॉर एवरी रन Look at that timeline. Too many singles. Crowd still coming in. looking for seats as close to the arena as possible. Last delivery of the over coming up from Saad bin Zafar. Slightly unlucky not to be among the wickets just yet. This time connected, and connected very well between two fielders, but very well fielded there by Babar Hayat of Hong Kong. That is the over bowled, five overs gone, 21 for 6 Flying Oryx.
Look at that, looks like a pin code of a city in India, 012204. Ravi, not a happy sight for Flying Oryx.
Definitely not a happy sight at all, as we have some wonderful sights of Qatar, the desert nation. Wonderful, the national animal, Oryx. Not easy to sight them, because they are way, way deep inside the deserts. Sunil and I haven't seen one yet.
We didn't get a break. We have a, fortunately, we have a match every day, so didn't get a chance to go deep inside the desert. Maybe we'll request the organizers to give us a break next time. This is how the boundary came. A very rare sight. Like that was saved boundary, in fact.
Babar Hayat doing all the running, and then you see tapping it back in. That's commitment for you. Oh, again a loud appeal. No response from umpire Qasir Wahid. Bilawal Iqbal should consider himself a trifle lucky. Got him on the back pad. Very, very close, that one.
I thought it was going to hit the leg stump, because the back leg, as you very rightly mentioned, very, very close shout.
We had two really close shouts in the previous over as well, turned down by umpire Mohammad Naseem. Both almost looking like crashing into middle stick.
Mistimed. Clears the infield and wins the race as well.
Babar Hayat a tad disappointed, because he did all the hard work and even managed to pull the ball back. Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain had a very, very shy grin. There you see Babar Hayat not giving up the chase, putting the ball back in, then the ball just rolls over. Just the second boundary of the innings. Chaudhary Iqbal cannot be complaining.
As a captain, definitely not.
Good
ball. Good change of line from Chaudhary Iqbal. Look at the fours. Just two so far. Second one came in this over. One time they were 16 for 6 after fourth over. So this partnership, the highest so far, added 10 runs. That's up in the air. Massive first six of the innings. Six gone, 32 for 6.
Even the VIP stands are looking pretty full. Very, very good turnout
And here's the first six of the match, crashed away by Harmandeep. Hits it over and taken. Maqsood. Waqas Maqsood it is. Judging it well. Didn't go too high. And Waqas Maqsood just followed it around the boundary to pick up that catch. And Flying Oryx could be the second team in the tournament to be bowled out within 10 overs. The first one, of course, Pearl Gladiators, who were bowled out for 67. Bilawal Iqbal goes for 5, 32 for 7, Flying Oryx.
Noman Sarwar is the new batsman in. Hasn't scored yet in the league. Good fielding on his own bowling by Zafar. Already charged up, got a wicket.
Well, he was without a wicket, so obviously he had reason to be charged up. His previous over went blank, but this time Waqas Maqsood judging it to perfection. LBW appeal, and umpire Muhammad Wasim says not out. Loud and clear. Noman Sarwar it is who escapes. Pitching on leg, possibly missing leg.
Very close shout, nonetheless. Very, very close.
Yo, well done. Well bowled. Very well bowled. Very well bowled.
More than a couple of close shouts have been turned down by the umpires tonight. Otherwise, this team was all out ready by now.
Oh, yes. Flying Oryx have done anything but fly. This time, outside edge will pick up another single. Just the first run. This is the wicket. Waqas Maqsood judging it perfectly. Good anticipation.
Very, very successful over. Just a run and one wicket from it. Quick single to end the over. Two runs and a wicket from it. Seven gone, 34 for seven. Balls remaining. Even if they get 15 and over, Ravi, that will take them to what, 70 at the max?
The lowest score in this tournament so far was 67 by Pearl Gladiators, and this one nearly decapitated his own bowler, Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain. But that's a commitment for you. Saad bin Zafar ducking out of harm's way. So he's bowled out. Murad Khan now. High in the air. Man coming under it. And takes it. Ahmad Bhatt just can't keep this man away from the action. Judges it to perfection, running around on the long on fence. Had to run a bit to his right, but stayed steady and then bounced it without any problems. So Harmandeep Singh departs for 15, 34 for 8, Flying Oryx.
Humanin Asif Abdul Rashid already 8 down his team at just 34. What a great bowling performance by Falcon Hunters, already smelling a victory and a place in the semi-finals.
Asif Abdul Rashid, the new man in, a best of 17 for him. That was in the match against Pearl Gladiators. This is the last wicket. Imad Butt getting under it and pouching it without any problems, judging it to perfection.
Just a single to the man at deep third man. Singles will not hurt the bowling team. They would be dreaming to bowl them out, Ravi.
Well, I think they should be disappointed if they don't, because they've still got 15 deliveries to pick up the final two wickets. And as all cricket lovers will know, when 8 are down, it's 9, 10 and jack.
Almost played on the new man, Asif Abdul Rashid.
Trying to pull it back. Already Chitranga De Silva has been dismissed in similar fashion, pulling one back from way outside the off stump, inside edge onto his stumps. Nothing seems to be going right for Flying Oryx tonight. Batsmen have really suffered.
If we look at the projection, 46 as per the current run rate. If they get 8 per over from here, we'll hardly pass 50 run mark. That's outside the off stump and a much required wide for them. He's happy doing that to Padmasan.
Just bounced over the stumps. So Asif had his share of luck. Asif Abdul Rashid.
Asif can bat a bit. Made 17 not out in the last game he played. A delivery to go in this over. Only 3 runs so far in the 5 deliveries. Look at his figure. Murad gave only 7 runs. Picked 2 wickets. But pick off the bowlers. Imad took 2 wickets without giving a run.
Batting much higher that day was Rashid, but this is Numanash Sarwar on strike. 8 overs gone, 37 for 8.
Balls remaining. The VIP gallery enjoying this game, especially the bowling. 8 overs gone, 8 wickets down. So the important question is, Ravi, will they bat
till the last ball. For the bowling team, Falcon Hunters will take all the 10 wickets.
...37 for 8 now. Ninth over in progress. Flying Oryx really suffering. Despite a good turnout today. This is the happy corner of the Falcon Hunters. Faisal Sandhu. Along with the chief of the Qatar Cricket Association. Trying to do too many things at the same time. Excited children in the crowd watching the action.
Tries to go for a big one, will get it. Finally, a big one for Flying Oryx. Takes them to 43.
Very well connected there by Asif. Got the height and the distance. Ball boy is not able to pouch that one. Another 100 dinars, Riyal's gone.
Didn't even go to the stands. Will settle for a single this time. So something to cheer for Flying Oryx. The sixes and all that, these kids want to see more and more. Let's see if Noman Sarwar is capable of such big shots or not.
Swings hard, but all along the ground. And Imad Bhatt, beg your pardon, is Waqas Maqsood, who's picks up and returns. So seven more deliveries remaining in this innings. 45 for 8. That's how bad this game has been for Flying Oryx.
In ball, ninth wicket out. The danger man Asif Abdul Rashid is the ninth man to go, and the opponent captain Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain makes his team owner happy.
Bowling absolutely flat and straight. Going, sitting down to get the elevation, but missing it completely. Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain doesn't miss. Middle stump uprooted, and Asif Abdul Rashid returns for 8. 9 down now for 45 Flying Oryx.
Six deliveries remaining. The last pair in the middle, Noman Sarwar and Bukhari. The first target for him. Slow one. Imad Bhatt has taken 2 wickets without giving a run, Ravi. What a performance from him.
This is Irfan Bukhari, who's here because this happened in the previous over. Asif Abdul Rashid trying to go for a one almighty hoik, but missing it completely. Iqbal Hussain Chaudhary doesn't miss. Middle stump uprooted.
Chaudhary also gets a wicket. Every bowler from his team is successful today. Will that be taken?
Yes is the answer. 45 all out. Flying Oryx. And third wicket without giving even a single run for Amat Bhatt. What a performance from his team.
Timur on the boundary line there, long off boundary. Judges it well, watches where his foot is, and then can afford to celebrate because his team has bowled the Falcon Oryx out for 45. Noman Sarwar the last man to go. And 45 all out. So Flying Oryx have got to dig themselves out of this hole now that they find themselves in. Three wickets without conceding a single run for Imad, but he's got a catch to boot as well. So man with the golden arm, one must say, as Flying Oryx, who were put into bat by the Falcon Hunters, have struggled. Only one double score in the double figures, 15 from Harmandeep. Otherwise, it leads like a phone number, 01220453 80.
That to a landline, Ravi. Not even a mobile number that starts with 7, 8 or 9. Look at the bowling figures. Everybody was successful, but pick of the bowlers, Imad Bhatt. 8 balls, no run given, 3 wickets picked up. Also, good bowling from Vakas, 2 for 8. Murad, 2 for 7, and a wicket each for Zafar and their captain, Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain.
So that's how things stand. Falcon Hunters need 46 runs in their 10 overs to book their place in the playoffs. We'll take a short break and come back with the chase. coming to you live from the Asian Town Cricket Stadium, and Flying Oryx, who were asked to bat first by Falcon Hunters, had suffered an early wicket, first delivery of the innings, and never really recovered from there, being bowled out for 45 in 9.2 overs. All the bowlers picking up at least a wicket each, two each for Vakas and Murad, three without conceding any runs for Imad Butt, who will put himself definitely in reckoning for the Man of the Match award, because he's also got a catch to his name. So a really good performance from Imad Butt. Two wickets each for Vakas Maqsood and Murad Khan. Zafar picks up one. Five extras contributing, adding to that 45. Second team after the Pearl Gladiators not to bat through the entire. That's the first ball. Success. Then straight to the mid-off-fielder. One after the other. This was the run out. This all this is happening in over number two. And then Imad Butt picks up a leg by. Down to the leg side. And then on leg W. That's the second success for Imad in that over. Four leg bys, of course, being added. But then the ball going high up in the air, wicketkeeper under it, pouches it, wicketkeeper Rizlan, Chitranga, De Silva didn't last long either. Rare boundary in the innings for Flying Oryx, saved, brilliant attempt there by Babar Hayat. Then this one was long and high, finally some thing to cheer about. But a good catch by Vakas Maqsood puts paid to that effort as well. And then this one was hit high, but pouched by Imad Butt on the boundary. Another six came through. Missed by the player on duty. And then a wicket for Chaudhary Iqbal Hussain as well. And this is how it all ended. Top edge taken on the boundary, and 45 is all that the Flying Oryx could manage in their 9.2 overs. It's a 10 over side contest. Alongside Sunil Taneja, I'm Ravi Kant Singh. Flying Oryx doesn't really do themselves any credit.
Only two partnerships in the double digits, Bilawal Harmandeep and Rashidan Noman. They added 11 runs. These are the wickets that fell. The first wicket going on the first ball. Then, of course, a catch at mid-off. The captain making no mistake. And this was a good run-out. Straight hit from the bowler.
Well, Sunil, it's remarkable that the highlights and the wickets both look so similar. Two sixes, two fours. That's all we had in the highlights package. And here, one after the other, the wickets keep falling. The ball, as the team perished without posting any kind of a challenge to the bowlers. Now it's up to the Falcon Hunters to come out and get those 46 runs, as every bowler in the Falcon Hunters side got among the wickets. At least one wicket for everyone. That is the final wicket. Swift Gallopers right at the top of the table, 6 points, confirmed their place in the playoffs. Desert Riders with five. Falcon Hunters with a win here will join Swift Gallopers on 6 points and also move into the playoffs. But the other four will have to fight it out. Remember, Friday is a holiday, so you've got a morning game. First game at 8:45 in the morning, and then one in the evening. That's how it will pan out on Friday. Thank you.
It is a beautiful country. Ravi and I are surely coming back with families after Qatar T10. It's a must-visit place. And the Asian Town Cricket Stadium is a great, great place for the game of cricket. Best crowd today. And we're expecting even a bigger crowd tomorrow, day after, and day after. The best on Monday, because that's the day when the finals will be played. The Indians, the Pakistanis, the Bangladeshis, the Sri Lankans, everybody is here to watch this man, Hashim Amla. Look at his T20 career. 27 50s. But here, his best is just 17. Made a duck and 9 thereafter. Expecting decent runs from him today, Ravi.
Superstars Salman Butt and Hashim Amla coming out to open. Offer of 100 riyals for the spectators. If they can catch a 6, it will be Hossein Talat who will get us underway, the Flying Oryx captain. 1 wicket for him so far, 4th match. Good delivery, cutting back into Hashim Amla, tucked him up quite a bit.
And Ravi, it's a good day for Hashim Amla to just hang in there. Hasn't been among the runs. Hashim Amla, the great hash, was here with us in the comm box 2 days back. But the target set in front of him is only 46, so he can take his time. And play a couple of shots whenever he feels like. And they need wickets. Very, very quick wickets. Amla is off the mark. Finds cap on the onside. There's a deep mid wicket. Amla will get 2.
How much ever international cricket you may have played, but the first runs always get the settle the butterflies down in your stomach. And that's what Hashim Amla would have felt, getting the ball at the middle of the bat. Very, very reassuring feel on your wrists. Opens the scoring for Falcon Hunters. Target a meager 46.
They're winning it for sure, Ravi. I mean, we can easily assume. But can they do it inside 5 overs? Outside edge will not carry. So Amla rotates the strike. Loses his bat.
Well, didn't do it the way he would have liked to. Outside edge, falling short of the lone slip fielder. Lucky. And another single for Hashim Amla, because Salman Butt was eager to get to the strike. The 3 of 3 for Amla. 3 without loss. Falcon Hunters. Target 46.
If you are defending such a low total, then you must give more than 100% in bowling and fielding. Stop the singles, stop the boundaries, catch everything that you see in the air. I mean the ball, not the flies. There aren't many, in fact. Outside off stump, Salman Butt will not take a run. There is no need to take any risk for the batsman.
When you're chasing 46, you're already quite satisfied. They've already got 3 runs in this over. So taking any kind of a risk would have been absolutely pointless. Fielder Chaturanga Da Silva. Salman Butt doing a bit of gardening there. Best crowd in the tournament so far. Thursday night. Expecting that to be better on Friday.
For Friday, let us remind you that the first match will be played at 8:40 a.m. That's tomorrow morning. 8:35 will be on air. And the second game, 8:25. So one game in the morning.
one game in the evening. 7:55 p.m. it is, the second game. That's a good shot. Well done. Let's see who the photographer is. Good job. Last ball of the first over coming up.
Crashed past the cover fielder, four runs, first boundary of the Falcon Hunters innings, one over ball, first ball lost.
अब्दुल रजाक
Bilawal Ikmal to continue the bowling. Hashim Amla made three in the three balls he faced in the first over. Salman Bhatt hit a boundary of the last ball. So if they go on like this, they should win the game most likely inside the five overs.
Well, teams have been trying to get to the five over mark with a 50 on board. If Falcon Hunters are also on track for that, they will definitely wrap it up and book their place in the playoffs. Then it will be jockeying for position, who plays whom. Oh, down the leg side. But let me tell you one thing. In the playoffs, every team would be trying to avoid swift gallopers.
Absolutely, Ravi. Can't agree with you more. Just remember a team whose main bowler is Mughis Bajwa and Umar Gul comes to bowl in fifth or sixth over. Imagine their firepower in the bowling. In the team that opens with Kamran Akmal, Zaheer Ibrahim, then Ali Imran, Ravinder Pal Singh is the team to beat. Hashim Amla, that's a good strategy. Take singles, stay there till the end, get some confidence. I mean, he's not short of confidence, but at least in this tournament, in this league, he needs to score a big total.
I think coming off a break, Amla looks a little rusty. And this would be a good game to try and push things along, get back in that rhythm. Looks pretty fit, despite having taken a break. There you see, playing it very, very confidently, close to his body, and takes off for a run, finishes it quietly.
He played in that Dubai T10 league also. Joined us in the Combox 2 days back. Very, very soft-spoken person. And asked him about his Gujarati skills. The only word he knew was Kemcho. And he replied by Kemcho with Kemcho.
And dropped. This one carried to the slips. Single results. Saad Naseem probably injured his finger in the process as well. Edge carried but flew out of his hand. When things are not, it's not your day, such kinds of things will happen. There you see the ball landing on the fingers and then flying away.
Maybe he closed his hands a bit earlier. It hurts when it happens.
Hurts more when you drop the catch. If you hold it, it doesn't hurt.
I agree. The physio is there to help him. But if you're defending a total of 45, doesn't matter how tough the catch is, you ought to take all of them.
Interested youngsters, little kids.
So we've got Musawar Shah on the field in place of the injured Saad Nassim. Bilawal Iqbal to continue. No ball called. So boundary off the no ball and a free hit to follow. Just slipping from bad to worse.
And Amla cannot be happier now. Got a boundary, will get a free hit. 29 more to win. Very close call. But as we have been mentioning, that line belongs to umpire. Some part of the foot should be behind the line.
So a free hit for the former South African captain. Although, to be very frank, I mean, free hits in this tournament haven't been the most profitable so far. We just had 1-6 out of about half a dozen free hits that have been on offer.
Twice Ravindrapal Singh was caught on free hits.
And caught means no boundary.
Yes. Can Hash score another one off the free hit? Finds the gap, but there's a fielder.
Again a no ball. So a no ball follows a no ball. Now, Sunil, quiz question for you. Does he get two free hits?
Should get more than that. Look at the over. Just two legal deliveries bowled. 9 runs already from this over. In fact, 10. Another free hit.
Well, actually, two no ball. Twice overstepping. He should be eligible for two free hits.
Not a bad idea. Not a bad idea. This time it's Salman Butt.
Field can change for the left-hander. Batsman had crossed over, so it's not the same batsman on strike. Now, let's see what Salman Butt can do. And we're still in the power play overs. So we've got a deep mid-wicket. And the mid-on fielder dropping back to long on. And short mid-wicket as well inside the 30-yard circle. So you got a backward square leg and a mid-on. Inside the power play. Free hit. Couldn't get hold of it. So a single is all they'll get. And love you, Chaudhary Iftikhar.
So both the corners of Falcon Hunters miss somebody daily and convey it on TV. So good to see the passionate team owners. They come to the ground after the innings is over, talk to the crowd, talk to our anchors. Another no ball. What's happening here?
Bilawal Iqbal looks like he's taken it upon himself to finish the game. 22 without loss already. And we are still, we've got what? 3 more legal deliveries to come in this over. Already 6 have been bowled.
13 runs have already come in the 3 balls. I think perhaps that's the same thing Mr. Sandhu is explaining to the QCA authorities. Look at the smile on the corner's face. He knows that his team is almost there in the semis. Makes room. Finds the gap, Salman Butt. 2-3 bounces over the ropes.
Target may be small, but the runs have got to be scored. And that's exactly what Salman Butt and Hashim Amla are doing. Going about their task without any hesitation. Free hit. Needed to be punished, and it was. Outside the off stump, smashed away. 2 more deliveries to go. Legal, I must explain, because this is the 9th delivery of the over.
Legal being the operative word, Ravi, because
absolutely,
already we have seen 3 or 4 no balls in this over.
Well, 3 no balls, 1 wide. So that's 4 extra deliveries. Amla on strike for what should be or could be the final delivery of this over.
think they are the fans of Hashim Amla, if I read the lips right. Already batting on 10. The great Hash will take a singer. Very expensive second over. Very long second over. 28 without loss after two. Look at the score, 28 without loss. This is tomorrow's match. The first game is in the morning. We'll be on air at 8:35 a.m. local time. Desert Riders will take on Heat Stormers. And the second game is at 8 p.m. local time. That's in the evening. We'll be on air at 7:55. Pearl Gladiators will take on Falcon Hunters. Falcon Hunters, if they win, they will be in the semis. So plenty of action for you tomorrow as well. It's a bowling change now. Noman Sarwar will try some of his spin bowling. Just 18 runs required. Remember, last over yielded 19 runs. This is the last over of power plays. A deep third man in place and a deep square leg. And straight away, the deep square leg fielder comes into action. They all know the result. It will be an easy win for the Falcon Hunters. Can they win by 10 wickets? The good thing is that Amla is there. He should be hanging there till the end. Salman Bhatt played a match-winning knock in the first game. Hit a last ball, 6. Seven balls left, 17 runs required. That's the easiest chase so far in this league. Required run rate 2.2 right now. We began with 4.6 of required run rate. Some fielding change. A deep cover is there for Hashim Amla. Outside the leg stump, called wide. So both the fielders on offside boundary for Hash. One deep third man, one deep cover. 5 balls remaining in the power play. This could well be the last over of the game, mind you. So 4 men inside the circle on onside and 1, 2, 3 on the off. Did not time it well. Salman Bhatt wanted a single. So tonight, Swift Calipers became the first team to cement their place in the semi-finals of the Qatar T10. Look at that. Very short. Very, very short delivery, that one. Could not time it well, Salman Bhatt. So Calipers are already in the semis. Falcon Hunters would be in the semis whenever they score 16 runs. Did not find the gap this time, Salman. And Desert Riders, they're playing tomorrow. If they win, they'll not only top the table, they will also become the third team to reach the semi-finals. And then we'll have Flying Oryx, Heat Stormers and Pearl Gladiators fighting for the fourth place. There it is. Swift Gallop has already qualified. Falcon Hunters will qualify after the win. Back live. What was that appeal about? So Heat Stormers and Pearl Gladiators yet to win a single game. Flying Oryx have won one game. Desert Riders with 2 victories. Falcon Hunters will win their third game tonight. Just some formality left. So 2 spots will be booked tonight. Some discipline in this over from the bowler, that is Noman Sarwar. Last over yielded 19 runs. This over has given only 3 runs in 5 balls. So again, my question is, can Falcon Hunters win inside 5 overs? It's very much possible. 13 deliveries to go for that. Another extra. Second wide of the over. Yes. Wide call now. Seven extras already in this innings of Falcon Hunters. One legal delivery to go. Go straight. Hashim Amla. That's a mighty blow. A boundary to end the over. Three gone. 36 without loss, Falcon Hunters. Ten runs remaining to win for Falcon Hunters to cement their place in the semi-finals. 7 overs remaining. Power play done and dusted. 36 without loss they are. Can this be the last over of the match? Is the question. And to proceed from here, Chitrangadhar Silva, who batted a bit today, is into the attack now. A spinner. Salman, but not happy with something. This is the last ball of the last over. And look at that. Pure class from Hashim Amla. Hit straight. Straight as an arrow. Shot straight to the man at long on. And let's go straight to my partner Avikant Singh, who is standing with Abdul Razak.
I have with me former Pakistan all-rounder Abdul Razak, who is the coach of the Falcon Hunters team. Very happy, coach, the way your team has played.
I'm basically is helping here with the mentor, and you know, we got coach Corey. And we got good combination with the management and with the players.
How do you think the tournament is shaping up?
Really excited and, you know, improving day by day. And you can see the standard of the cricket going high. And, you know, a lot of Pakistani players came from the Pakistan. And, you know, they're playing very good cricket. And now you can see bowling, batting, fielding. Standard gone up.
Oh, well. Apart from Falcon Hunters, I think the one team that is really performing well is Swift Gallopers. So you see yourself there as main contenders?
Definitely. Out of competition, you know, if we got 6 team, might be 2 or 3 team, they made good combination and they're performing well. Main thing, if you understand the format of T10, then you can perform. I think they're believing and they're playing like a T10 cricket.
What, in your thing, is the strength of T10 cricket, batting or bowling, in your team?
It's very difficult to say, but this is, I think, batsman game, you know. Batsmen really enjoy it and very tough with the bowlers, and especially for fielding. because you don't have time. Batsmen can hit you, you know, everywhere, you know. For bowler, they don't have time. They have to bowl well from the first of last six ball.
Well, we've seen some very high scores, and your team has been one of them to get past 100. Now, you think 120 or is a good score?
You will see the. We have seen the T10 Abu Dhabi T10 cricket, but there the standard 130, 25 runs their team making. But now you can see here 153 runs Kamran Akmal team they made. So hopefully, I think 150 and 20 run I reckon is good total for defend.
As a bowler, what would you advise? Because you have been a bowler, international bowler yourself, very successful. What would you advise bowlers to bowling here?
Use your brain and use your skill, mainly willpower. If you're scared from hitting, you cannot bowl in T10.
And your fielding side, because there's a lot of dew as well.
It's happened, we played so many games in Dubai as well, but it's happened. Come, you have to be, you know, I think you have to be see as if dews come and air come, you know, does not matter. You have to be adjust yourself.
Well, wish you all the best for your team for the rest of the tournament. So that was Abdul Razak talking to us. Back to you, Sunil.
Thank you, Ravi. Last ball of the fourth over yields a single, four gone, 43 without loss.
काट दिया उसने यार
नहीं नहीं ब्रेक है ब्रेक है
राम ज्यादा है कभी सकता है
ये भी हो सकता है हां और क्या सिंह रिप्लेसिंग सिंह
फ्री में यार
सिंह रिप्लेसिंग सिंह
और रविकांत सिंह इज हैविंग फन विद द कोऑनर्स ऑफ फाल्कन हंटर्स There's another Mr. Singh. Name is Hansveer Singh. All smiles, all around. Just formality left. Three runs required. Can Salman finish the game with a boundary? Welcome back, Ravi. This could be the last ball. No, a couple more at least. Maybe one.
Well, the crowd wants to see more, definitely. So they don't want things to be finishing in a hurry. And there, the two happy co-owners really enjoying themselves.
Mr. Saeed and Mr. Sandhu cannot be happier. Team is just a formality away from reaching the semi-finals.
This will be the biggest margin of victory by 10 wickets. Five overs to go from what it looks like now.
Hash is in no hurry, just dealing in singles. He also knows, maybe realizes that crowd wants to see them more. Scores tied now.
Crown's curator, Shakil Ahmed, to the extreme right, along with his team. Needs to be commended because we just had a score of 116. Shakil Malik, a very happy man yesterday. We could get two games and a score of 153 on a not-so-dry wicket. Crowd on its feet now, knows it's all over by the shouting.
A full shot, a boundary to win the match. Salman Butt is happy. Falcon Hunters are happy. Their supporters are happy. Their co-owners are very, very happy. Mr. Saeed and Mr. Sandhu. Falcon Hunters become the second team to reach the semi-finals of the Qatar T10 Cricket League. Congratulations.
And they have done it in style. Always trying to go better than Swift Gallopers, who beat Pearl Gladiators earlier in the evening by 48 runs. And now Falcon Hunters have crushed Flying Oryx by 10 wickets. No doubt. Unbeaten Hashim Amla, unbeaten Salman Butt. Salman Butt on 20, Amla on 22. That's the winning hit from Salman Butt. No real effort to save that one by the fielding side. They knew it was already over. So Salman Butt has the honor of hitting the winning runs. Two international stars walking back, Hashim Amla and Salman Butt. Very, very modest target ahead of them. 46 runs and did it win 4.3 overs. So that will definitely give a big boost to their net run rate as well, Falcon Hunters. And that will come in handy when the teams are jostling for position.
Well, nothing to look here. Bilawal bowled one over, went for 19. And Hamandeep only bowled three balls, gave away six runs. Hussain, one over, nine runs. Noman and De Silva, one over each, gave seven each as well. That's a match summary. Flying Gorex made just 42, bowled out in 9.2 overs, all thanks to those great figures. Look at figures of Amat Butt. Did not give a run, picked up three wickets, two wickets each for Murad and Waqas, and then the chase was very, very easy for Falcon Hunters.
So Hunters have won by 10 wickets to book their place in the playoffs, and now we'll take a short break and come back with the post-match presentation.
So ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the presentation ceremony. And once again, Falcon Hunters outshine. It is definitely a winning moment for them. And the boy who is declared man of the match today is none other than Amat Butt with 1.2 overs, 0 runs and 3 wickets. Congratulations, Amat. To do the honors, we have Mr. Al-Khawari, President QCA. owners of Falcon Hunters, and Sajjad Chaudhary, CEO, International Pro Event. Many congratulations. Jis tarah se aapne bowling kari aur bina run diye teen wicket liye, this is something amazing. So aaj kuch naya try karne ka socha tha game mein ya it was just your day?
सबसे पहले तो मैं अल्लाह ताला का शुक्र अदा करता हूँ कि उसने ये इज़्ज़त दी है. एक्चुअली T10 है तो आप एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं इस तरह के, हर बंदा जो है ना वो रन्स की तरफ जा रहा होता है, बाउंड्री की तरफ, तो इस तरह के मैं हैपेंड ही कहूँगा कि हो सकते हैं.
पर जिस तरह से फ्लाइंग ऑरिक्स को 50 के भी अंदर समेट दिया गया था, तो क्या कॉन्फिडेंस वहीं से बन गया था, पता था कि आज का गेम तो हमारे हाथ में है, या फिर क्योंकि T10 है तो कुछ भी हो सकता है, यू वर प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर दैट?
जी बिल्कुल, जिस तरह से आप कह सकते हैं क्रिकेट बाय चांस है तो कुछ भी हो सकता है, लेकिन पिछले मैच से जिस तरह के प्लेयर खेल रहे थे जेलो होके, तो लग रहा था कि इंशाल्लाह ताला विन करेंगे.
No worries. Thank you very much. Wishing you all the very best. And once again, team, many congratulations. We are looking forward for some more winning strokes. That's all from the presentation ceremony. Thank you very much.
Well, the crowd came to see the international players and they were not disappointed, as Hashim Amla and Salman Butt got their team to a 10-wicket victory, batting it out through 4.3 overs. So certainly a fill they had. And in the, this is how that they stack up. Swift Gallopers and Falcon Hunters through to the playoffs with 6 points each. Desert Riders and Flying Oryx still in contention, but Heat Stormers and Flirt Gladiators not yet out of the reckoning, because they can still, because they've got two matches in hand, they can still catch up and move up the table. Top four teams qualify for the semi-finals. Two there, two more to follow. Tomorrow, it's an early start. Remember, it's a Friday here in Qatar. So Desert Riders face off with Heat Stormers at 8:45 a.m. local time. We'll be on air at 8:35, 5 minutes before the official start of the match. That will be followed by an evening game. 8 p.m., it's Pearl Gladiators versus Falcon Hunters again in action. We'll be back on 5 minutes before the start at 7:55 p.m. here at the Asian Town Cricket Stadium. So that is all from tonight. We'll see you tomorrow morning. Bye for now.